So thank you very much for the invitation, and my great pleasure to share with you some of the research on les immatériaux that I have done in the past years. And there's going to be a lot of resonance with the previous talk, and I'm really looking forward to the debate, because my main focus is on philosophy of technology. So I'm working on the articles in different medium and interface. But, I think that, like all of you, like me, we are too young to have seen the exhibition. And it is really difficult to understand the exhibition just by looking and reading the catalogue. So I allow myself to play 5 minutes of a video, and I hope that will allow you to understand more what is happening. So only 5 minutes, and then I'll come back to the talk.
Est celle de la présence. Quelqu'un vous parle au téléphone, n'est pas là. Vous regardez la télévision, ce que vous voyez n'est pas là. Mais c'est là quand même. C'est la même chose pour les savants. Ils voient des choses qu'ils ne voient pas, qu'ils ne peuvent pas voir. C'est la même chose, bien sûr, pour les technologies. Nous sommes environnés d'une quantité de machines, de réception ou d'action qui étendent nos capacités de sentir et d'agir. Ça transforme complètement notre rapport avec ce qu'on appelle la matière. Donc la question que nous nous posons dans les immatériaux, dans ce terme, c'est la question de savoir ce qui est réel et ce qui n'est pas aujourd'hui. Nous vivons dans un univers d'artefacts, de prothèses de toutes sortes. Et la question qui se pose est de savoir quel rapport l'homme a avec cet univers.
Le propos déjà, paradoxalement, imposait que ce ne soit pas une exposition. Une exposition n'était pas la réponse en termes d'expression, en termes de médias, je dirais. L'exposition n'était pas la réponse au propos. Dans la mesure, justement, une exposition, c'est un tracé, c'est un parcours contraint, prédéterminé. Et une exposition, traditionnellement, c'est ici et maintenant.
Avait vu Jean-François, un Américain avait mis 9 minutes 45 secondes pour visiter le musée du Louvre. Ils décidèrent de faire mieux. Thank you.
propos des immatériaux, c'est l'inverse de ça. C'est de faire sentir, de montrer le trouble, l'inquiétude et le flou. Le visiteur est seul, responsable, sous un casque, responsable de l'interprétation qu'il donne de ce qu'il entend, de ce qu'il voit. Il construit le sens en cheminant de domaine en domaine, complètement différents les uns des autres.
Ces messages sont transmis.
So we stop here, or we can just watch the video for now. So I hope that gives you a kind of idea of the whole setting of Les Immatériaux. And so since 2013, we have been doing this with my colleague Andreas Buchmann, who is a historian of art. So we have also a book that you can download online, which contains an article from Lyotard, which is not published in French yet, and it's very rich. It's his framework of the whole exhibition. Now, but what is Les Immatériaux? As you have heard, it's not an exhibition. And actually, I have been working on that since 2 years, but I don't really know how to explain what this is. No, it is an exhibition, is a non-exhibition, is a manifestation, is an event, is a work of art that Lyotard described. It is a joint between two epochs, the modern, postmodern. It is a projection to the future. The future of technology. It is also a legacy of François Lyotard. It is also an institutional politics or display, because it was organized within the Center of Industrial Creation. And after this exhibition, the center was closed. But today, if you go to Centre Pompidou, you can still find that this association exists. But nobody there. So the complexity of these significations makes the events very interesting and difficult to analyze. And actually, the exhibition was renamed several times. The first time it was called Creation and New Material. Then New Material and Creation. I don't see the difference. And then Material in all its state. And not until the autumn of 1983, the arrival of Lyotard to join Thierry Chaput to organize this exhibition, then the thematic was set and the title was chosen, Les Immatériaux. No, but it is very clear, as we can see, that it is what is called Les Immatériaux is actually a kind of a new material that is brought by the telecommunication technologies, in biology, in chemistry. The reason of choosing Les Immatériaux, immaterial, is that Lyotard wanted to create a discontinuity with the modern conception of matter and materiality. So what he said is that if I call it new material in creation, then people will think that this is going to be the continuation of the modern project. So the negation of in before the material, is actually a new kind of materialism. But this new materialism is neither vitalist materialism. That means there's kind of vitality in kind of vibrant matter that many people are talking about today. It is neither deterministic materialism, meaning that our way of living and is determined by the technological settings and material settings, a kind of old Marxist analysis. At the same time, it is also a special period in history. I mean, 1985, it is 6 years after the publication of the postmodern tradition. It is also the emergence of post-structuralism that was already there, and also the linguistic turn that we know in contemporary theory. So for Lyotard, the exhibition, as you have heard, it is you want to present or to provoke a kind of new sensibility, a sensibility, and that is a very important term we have to bear in mind. A sensibility was called forward to understand the transformation of the material condition, driven by, especially by the industry. As we will see later in the examples, in chemistry, biology, physics, and so on and so forth, and especially information technologies. Now, the question of sensibility is one of the concepts that Les Immatériaux want to start. He started with the question of sensibility and answers us throughout the whole preparation and also in the exhibition. And there's an interesting dialogue we can imagine of, on one side, sensibility and the material. Well, what is the relation between sensibility and material? And I would like to show that how Lyotard finally is trying to situate sensibility between two extremes of that Charles also demonstrated in the understanding of nature in the 18th century. But I will come back to this later. But okay, the question of sensibility. And as an après-coup, today we may even have a more elaborate idea of what sensibility is than the exhibition does. So firstly, it is a sensibility towards what is under transformation. Sensitive to what is under transformation in different aspects of our society. And secondly, it is also a search, a sensibility of what is happening inside us. That is what Lyotard has discovered in the confession of outer skin, the inhumanness. This is the inhumanness. And thirdly, it is also sensibility towards history. Discover in our history that there are always already traces of the postmodern. So, for example, in Augustine, in Diderot, that we will come back later. And the sensibility also allows us to question the legitimacy of what defines our existence and knowledge, laws that were produced during the European modernity. And those revolutionary discoveries, I mean, those effects that Charles has presented, and it doesn't mean that they are not true anymore, but indeed that the question is that a new kind of sensitivity is needed to understand what is happening today. Now, the modern concept, like rules and practices, for example, the certainty, the question of certainty, that was once the aim of early modern science. For example, the search for certainty, for truth detached from everyday experience. For example, the geometrical perfection, as it was in the case of Kepler, of Galileo, Descartes, and others. And these modern concepts, rules, and practices must be put into question in order to liberate, those values that have been since long imprisoned. And in the catalogue of the exhibition, we can read that Lyotard wanted to liberate material, the matter. He said the immaterial material has been imprisoned by the industry since long time. And the exhibition has its goal to liberate matter. So you know, you see that this kind of understanding of matter is not kind of to take matter as a determination, but rather to think that as matter is also an object of alienation. You know, so we have to liberate matter. So at this center to the question of sensibility for Lyotard is the question of insecurity. So that is what he says, the insecurity, the loss of identity, the crisis is not expressed only in the economy and the social, but also in the domains of the sensibility, the knowledge and the power of man, the modes of life. And we can understand that right after this exhibition, there was a lot of critique against Lyotard. So, for example, there was a journalist and a writer, filmmaker Michel Cuno, has written an article on Le Monde criticizing Lyotard, saying that the exhibition was an insult of the public because it made you feel really nervous. And there's not much thing to say. And this is a defense of Lyotard, who is afraid of Les Immatériaux. So he provoked kind of in the public a kind of uncertainty and insecurity. Of course, there was also celebrations of this exhibition. It is a way of to sensibilize the great change of today. And this also became to describe it's a non-exhibition. And why is it a non-exhibition? Because it is a kind of mixture of objects. There's not only painting. There are not many paintings, only a few of them. But many of them are kind of objects like this. For example, as you have seen, that you have to wear a headphone to go through the tunnel, and then end of the tunnel. The tunnel starts with an Egyptian statue and ends with the distorted statue. And in the tunnel, it's totally dark. So you have seen, and you hear strange music. And you see some objects like, for example, the second skin, the artificial skin. You see how the robot worked with car. It's I forgot which company that they got this robot from. You have the artificial odor, the smell. You also have new communication technologies, and also a scenography, which is provoke you, like confuse you, as if you are in a maze. And also, the whole cosmology is changing with the death and birth of planets and stars. As I said, there was kind of complexity concerning the whole thing. So I would like simply to mention 3 points. The question of the postmodern in this exhibition, the question of new materiality in relation to the work of Lyotard, and also the question of informatization that happened during the period throughout 1970s and in the 80s. No, because François asked me to add something on Greenberg, so I added a slide to please him. So I'm not going to talk through this, but I just want to show that what is behind that can serve as a background information for us to think of exhibition as a medium, and we can also chase not really archaeology, but genealogy of that. And so I've written an article that's coming out, and I'm really happy that my friend Adina is here, who wrote this with me. But I simply mentioned 3 points and then we put this as a background information to think of medium as a modulation of the sensible. So this is the question related to the sensibility. The second point is to understand medium, the function between the Umwelt. Now the Umwelt is what the internal world of the animal, and the Umgebung. The Umgebung is the physical environment. The medium is what function between these two. And this kind of the way to the intention was kind of against the Greenberg's determinism, the media determinism. Also the concept in anthropology that the question of Umwelt is the question of animal. So only in historical anthropology they believe that only animal has Umwelt and human have Welt. So human has the world, but the animal we can only talk about Umwelt. So this is also a challenge of certain kind of this continuity between human and non-human, and which I think is also central to the thought of Lyotard. And thirdly, this the medium is to think of the whole international, institutional and the transnational setting of the exhibition. But let's start with the question of the first question of the postmodern. And we know that Lyotard became really famous because of his publication of the postmodern condition in 1979, which was actually a report commissioned by the Quebec government to study the state of knowledge. So what is the state of knowledge and knowledge production after the post-industrial society? So this book, Modern et après, is a question. Is a book that published right after Les Immatériaux, and it contains a lot of historical information about the exhibition and the interviews. I assume that after more than 35 years, I don't have to explain what is the postmodern, so I will skip this step. The one thing I want to mention that what is very important is that for Lyotard in the exhibition, so we see there's objects like a theater without body. There's the second skin that we have seen, the dark tunnel and the strange sound from the headphone, the animation of the cosmogenesis, everything that gives the sensibility. That human is no longer at the center of the world, and of course this is not the news for us today, but it's still the fact. But what is important here is that the rules and order that has drawn from mathematics, the laws of nature introduced by Descartes, the a priori concepts legitimated by Kant in the critique of the pure reason seems destabilized in the disorientation of the postmodern. And that's one point, it's interesting that Lyotard wanted to think of a moment where the unpresentable is put forward in presentation itself. So the unpresentable is put in the presentation. And what does it mean by that? What is it? There is a contradiction here. The unpresentable in presentation. Because it is also the version of the sublime that Lyotard wanted to provoke in the exhibition. And Lyotard actually found his accompany in the first half of the critique of judgment of Kant. And I would like also to kind of, so the first part is about the aesthetic judgment and the analytic of the sublime. And why is this interesting? I would like to relate this to the thought of Charles. Let me put this in a simple way. So if in the 18th century, there was a shift from the understanding of nature, meaning the mechanical rules, that was introduced as the laws of nature. The laws of nature was a modern invention. On one hand, there's mechanical laws that was exemplified in Kant's critique of pure reason. You have the a priori laws. And then there's also a view of organism, of the organic, that is presented by Kant in the second part of his critique of judgment, in the teleological judgment. Now what I see is that Lyotard wants to put the question of aesthetics, that's meaning the sensible, the sensibility, in between these two. Why Lyotard didn't want to talk about teleology? And that was very clear in he had given a lecture called the Lesson of the Analytic of Sublime, but it's only on the 29th session of the book. Now, one of the reasons, I think, is that because the concept of the organic that was later taken on by philosophers, for example, Schelling and Hegel, that with this idea of the organic is able to develop a kind of totality, a totality or totalization that Lyotard wanted to escape. Now, so there was something that the unpresentable in the presentation is that something that cannot be fit into the mechanical rules, and something that cannot be totalized in the whole concept of the organic, and especially when you think of the idea of how the organic was come to the pinnacle in the writing of Schelling on the general organism, the agamine organisms in his book on the world soul in 1799. So, there is something that cannot be put, but the kind of contradiction, and Lyotard continue to develop his logic, for example, in the writing on Basha Etienne's work. And he emphasized on the sentence, "I remember what I do not remember." I remember what I do not remember. So in the preparation, Lyotard's target, of course, is against the modern, so against Descartes. And for example, in Descartes in the discourse of method, he talked about urbanism and architecture, and he was saying that the appearance was so chaotic and the development, the design was so childish. So just redo it again with perfect geometry. But he probably had the mind of Amsterdam of 1662 in mind. And I took this slide from one of the presentations of Dastok, of Rohan Dastok. But what Lyotard has in mind, and he was another thinker, and that we have heard in the last talk. And the 1767 of this writing on the Salon of 1767 was so important for Lyotard to conceptualize the scenography of the exhibition. And as Charles has briefly described, but I add a few words to that, it's the Salon consists of seven sides. And the question of what is real, what is imitation, was totally blurred in the Salon. And Venice's painting for Diderot was give you a kind of landscape that you question yourself, is it not real, or is it really a painting? And as he developed in other writings, provoked that he asked the question, what prevents me to realize one day that actually my dream, what I have dreamed and what I have thought, are actually real? So is that there was kind of experience of that mix up what is simulation and what is real. And what beyond that is also the question of the sublime. That because in 1767, Diderot, you can correct me if I'm wrong, I think that Diderot has already read the book by Burke, a philosophical inquiry into the origin of our ideas of the sublime and beautiful. So in this writing of 1767, so the question of sublime also emerged sometimes. For example, something is a burning, and Diderot was talking to Abbé, the figure that he invented in this writing, said that there was two persons in me. There is a roofer, a worker who worked on the roof. He's so painful because of what is burning. But there's also me, you know, as an observer, that there was a kind of pleasure in me. So there's at the same time painful and the pleasure. And consider how this is transformed into the Salon, that the question of the sight was taken up. And in this exhibition, there was 61 sites. There were 61 sites. And they were arranged in a way kind of against the Cartesian imagination of Paris, of this ideal Paris. So here are some of the images of the scenography. And there are many things that were hanging down from the ceiling. They cut to the side. But there's not much information available because the architect Philippe Delis, who died, as if he died 2 years ago. So we were trying to organize an interview, but this didn't happen. Right. So the second concept I would want to talk and relate to the question of sensibility is meta. So for Lyotard, the idea of retaking the question of matter and net is trying to... It's a very complicated, but we'll see, because I cannot summarize it. But Lyotard was... for him, if the term, the root net means like to make with your hand, and make you. And if for the modern, it means something... If matter means something that we can master, something we can manipulate. And Lyotard want to provoke here is that actually we must understand matter in a totally different way. And human being is no longer the center of the world, and we are not the producer of matter, we are not the person who can manipulate it. He was looking for a metaphysics. And he, at some point, he didn't really continue, but he was saying that we should develop a metaphysics of interaction, metaphysics that is compatible with the interaction. He referred to Spinoza, and referred to the Japanese Zen Buddhist called Dogen. In this conceptualization, everything is only products of the interaction of particles, of waves, of subatomic activities. But Lyotard didn't go into the question of subatomic metaphysics. But he kind of materialism, that's really... funny in a way that he goes to language. So if in the exhibition you always start with the question of the body, but you always end up with the question of language during the exhibition. How can we understand this? Now, in 1983, Lyotard published a book, The Different, which is a book that he called My Book of Philosophy. So it's a really philosophical work. And what exactly is this book? It is actually a materialist analysis of language in the spirit of Kant's third critique. and Wittgenstein's philosophical investigation, and some of the later texts were from Wittgenstein. And he analyzed language according to its different regimes of discourse and the possible conflict linkages between different sentences. While at the same time he attempts to read philosophy from Plato to Kant according to this framework. We can imagine this model materially. So, for example, there's one sentence coming, there's another sentence coming, and you think of two material beings coming. So how can you, if there's a conflict between these two matters, how are you going to resolve it? And if there's a linkage, how do we know that these two sentences are connected to each other? So you have to make a link. So there's a kind of a materialist understanding of language here, and the further he developed into this model that is richer, than in the 1983 book. Now we have five concepts developed from the map. We have the maternity that is the approach that goes to the Plato's Timaeus of the receptacle as the foster mother. And you have the receiver, which is the material, which is also the hardware. And the message is supported by the material. There's a material support, and there's a matrix that regulate how the message is formatted. And there is a reference to something that is a message that's referred to. So this is the his description of what I have mentioned. And by thinking of this setting, so yes, I want to say that a human being is no longer the creator of these messages, but only part of this message. It can be a receiver, it can be also some contribute to the matrix and so on and so forth. And it's also, because it's also interesting to see the word plasticity that Lyotard has already used. Is that this plasticity of human means that the structure of communication today seems like something up on which identities can no longer be fixed. We can no longer say that in the structure of communication, man is, for example, in the role of the sender any more than that of the receiver. And according to these five poles, so all the sites of the exhibition are classified according to these five maps, maternity, material, and so on and so forth, in a kind of chaotic manner. And what is, besides of these five poles, there is also something outside the exhibition, and this is called the Atelier de Culture. It is a fantastic project, if you didn't know what it is yet. It is actually a collaborative writing project between consisting of 50 keywords. They invite Derrida, Bruno Latour, Stengers, François Châtelet, all these famous scientists and philosophers to write keywords together, and they can comment on each other. And you can imagine that Derrida or Châtelet this picture of Châtelet, was really happy that he thinks that everything has changed, that his writing experience was totally changed. So there was a collaborative writing project at the time. And everyone received a Minitel, a machine. And I was talking to Bernard Bristem, the director of the center, and he was telling me that in the summer afternoon, he was carrying the Minitel machine to the house of Derrida, and to teach Derrida how to use the Minitel to comment on. To write an article, very beautiful memory. So you can imagine in the way that the question of the author was questioned. So there's no author, because that was also one way of one of the aim of the exhibition is to dissolve the question of the author, of the human, of the but of course, it's interesting also to see today that it is so easy to do this today, you know, with either pad or the Google Doc. But after this experiment of real time, we haven't seen anything. It doesn't mean that we have a better technology, that something better will happen.
That's François Châtelet in the moment.
Yes. He was he was really happy because maybe later if we have time we can also look at the in the video there was an interview of him, and he was talking about the transformation of his writing experience by the minute there. So now this is the third aspect that I wanted to mention is the question of information. The question of information was important because let's recall that the postmodern condition, the report that Lyotard has written in 1979, was believed to be one of the aim was the response to the book, to the report in France published a few years earlier, the informatisation of society by the two computer scientists, Simon Nora and what is the name of the other person?
Nick.
So it was a response to the question of informatisation of the society, and what is knowledge, what is sensibility, what is living in the in this new transformation. So we have this in background, but there's Lyotard also responding to this, and by the end we'll come back to that. But Lyotard was not really following what informatization means. There was kind of a resistance from Lyotard. But if we go back to what I have just showed, how different is this model from what we know today in computer science, in informatics? You have the sender, you have the receiver, you have the material support, a channel or a cable. You also have a reference of the message. And you have the matrix of the message, meaning the coding scheme. Either it can be cryptography or not, as you like. But the question is, how different is this model from what we know today in computer science, in informatics? And according to Lyotard himself, according to Lyotard himself, this model was influenced by Roman Jacobson, by Norbert Wiener, the father of cybernetics, also by the communication scientist Harold Laswell. Now, he repeated many times that he was influenced by these people. But according to historian Anthony Hudek, who did his PhD on the history of Les Immatériaux, he pointed out that this was not true. Lyotard simply invented this model himself, because there was some evidence that when he spelled the name Laswell, it was all wrong. He spelled the name wrong in all the occasions. So what I was trying to say here, you know, like the similarity between this model is how much it was influenced by the whole concept of the informatization of the society in the epoch, in the 1970s and early 1980s. And that was, he was addressing this question in the album, the passage from the society of energy to the society of intensive information, impulses, functions, and the behaviors that are not very different, corresponding to the new modes of perception, representation, and symbolization, the different ways of decision, conception, and production. So this is clear. But if we, it would be interesting if we step outside the exhibition, if we step outside the exhibition and see how the discourse of informatization has affected museums and exhibitions during the 70s and in the early 80s. So I'm in debt a lot to the research from Adina on Pontus Hulten, that actually in 1970s, Hulten was the first director of the Centre Pompidou, and he was already talking about imagining the museum as a place of communication and information. And what he means by this image was really that was from 1971. Primary information, so that's as we can imagine, teletype is actually, I think it was kind of some machine in between computer and the typewriter. I think it existed some time in the history before I was born, so I don't really know much. And there is also space too for information processing, workshop, atelier for artists, for the public, process the information, films, music, and dance theater, collections of artwork, archives of films. So you can imagine the 1970s, there was already this idea of the informatization and the communication. And the whole the Centre Pompidou was considered to be a kind of communication model, a model communication, and from the perspective of architecture as well. There was a kind of already revealed in the interview with the architect, but it is delicate to claim that Les Immatériaux is an example of cybernetisation of this period. But it is true that the question of communication is crucial to the whole conceptualization and the design of the exhibition. Now, outside the exhibition, besides of the l'épreuve d'écriture that I have showed, there was also experiments of video conferencing between Berlin, Paris, London, São Paulo, Tokyo. Imagine 1985, you are doing Skype already. But the question is that I don't know if they have succeeded in doing that, because there was a lot of communication problem, and I think that one of the person who was working in the Canada research lab was Finberg, Andrew Finberg, the philosopher of technology. Now, the word digital was not yet the word digital was not yet used in this period. Lyotard only used telegraph, which plays a very important role in his later writings. But what is interesting, if you look at the logo of this of the exhibition, you know, the fingerprint is a empreinte digitale. It's also it makes a lot of association to the question of the digital in other languages, and of course today we also use in French numeric or digital. So I have 3 minutes and I will finish. Now, the notion of information also allow us to look into the question of exhibition, of experience in the exhibition, and how information becomes a question to understand medium, which modulates the sensible and the sensibility, and also the sensibility inside and outside the exhibition, like some sort of dramaturgy. You know, so the exhibition what is so significant about the exhibition is not that it addresses one epistemological question or two epistemological questions, but it opened an epoch. It opened an epoch, an imagination. But however, I'm not going further into this point about modulation of the sensible, because then that will be rather a seminar on Simon Bon rather than Lyotard. Now, lastly, I would like to come back to the question of the inhuman that that I provoked at the very beginning, that Lyotard was talking about inhuman and the confession of Augustine. And it is said, according to a dialogue between Philippe Parolo and Hans Ulrich Ubrist, that Lyotard was planning another exhibition as a continuation of Les Immatériaux. It's called the Resistance, the Resistance, that is the exhibition that he wanted to iterate. And actually, I haven't come across anything that Lyotard has this plan, and it seems that it's unknown to his close friend. However, I would like to speculate that in between Les Immatériaux and Les Résistances, if it was really the idea, then what resonates in between is the concept of the inhuman. And it also allows us to make contemporary the idea of Lyotard, to the post-human, to the transhuman, to the non-human. But this will be still a task for the future. But I would like quickly to mention that last year in the in Council in the Friedrichshain, and it's a really difficult pronounce, but I think Tristan, you were there, no? To give the talk once.
Yeah, but
one series yeah. of that, yeah, because they curated three exhibitions, so this was the third dedicated to the question of the inhuman. So I just to as an ending to show that how much resonance we can still bring from Les Immatériaux to make it contemporary to the discourse on aesthetics, on exhibition, on curation, and philosophy. So thank you very much for your attention.
Thank you.